this bathroom. It's so crazy. When you put in new lights, the lights are being so bright. I am trying something new, guys. I've been tired of my hair looking the way it's looking. I want to do something. Add some little bump and put the ass to it. It's been raving on TikTok. I mean, I'm always late when it gets to trends, but I have some socks that I got from the dollar store, and these are men's socks. These are brand new socks on top of that. So I'm gonna do 6 parts of my hair. I'm gonna wrap my hair around these socks, and yeah, that's what I wanna do. So really quick update. Today is Tuesday the 9th. Still haven't heard anything. Still waiting for my keys. I am actually off tomorrow, Thursday, Friday. Well, I am actually going into work tomorrow. So hopefully I'm just gonna go to work until I hear something. Like, seriously, but I was really hoping to hear something by Thursday so I can get things situated, but it's just so hard to plan anything because I don't have my freaking keys yet. So as far as PTO, as far as transferring my utilities, as far as transferring, you know what I'm saying? It's just been a hassle. It's been like a pain in the butt. It's getting on my nerves, and like, I'm over it. Okay. I am so over it, but right now I am going to sock wrap my hair up. I just put a little bit of oil to give it some life, and I'm about to wrap this bad boy up because I just don't want my hair to be an issue for the next couple days. So we're gonna see how crazy this is gonna look next. Somebody's in the bath. I just got done sock curling my hair. This side looks a lot tighter than this side. I don't know. Maybe I need to. Well, I think, you know what's crazy? I can't find any of my bonnets right now. I know you guys are like, what the heck is you doing? You guys will see. You laugh at me now, but wait till the morning. I want to fix this one now. This one is like, these ones are so, like, especially this one is like tight. And the thing about it is they're soft, so I can lay on it. So I'm going to redo this one. This one's like slipping. I don't mind having my hair at the top the way it is. I just want that spiral curl. I don't know. We're going to see how this works. Look at this mess over here, y'all. I'm so ready to move. Good morning, Gravers. It's early. Well, not early early, but y'all, I did the sock treatment to my hair and I absolutely loving the results. Oh my gosh, y'all. Ooh wee. Hold on. I really absolutely just love, it's cute.
You ever want to go through something and then the whole process of something just takes so much out of you that you don't even want to go through process no more? That is where I'm at currently. So today is Wednesday the 10th, okay? Now, and I'll be going through this whole process with this house. First, negotiations back and forth, then finally got it to where we're closing, to where, oh, we can't close because, oh, we're missing some document information about the tax lien to the property. So now I'm getting, not me, but I see like the seller, because with the closings, you know, title closings, the seller, and then now my end now is now like getting, you know, upset about everything because why is the process taking so goddamn long? Like, it's really irritating me, y'all. Like, I'm not kidding. And I'm just like, what is going on? So my thing is this, like, I'm over it and waiting, anticipating on moving for about a month now. About a month, okay? Because when I found out that we were good with negotiations, we're all good to go. All right, cool. That was the 16th. It is now the 10th. And this, I should have been, I was supposed to close on the 30th. Well, that didn't happen because of this situation that's been going on. I didn't want to get online and start venting about this stuff, but you know what, y'all? I understand closing and stuff with houses. This is not an easy process. But like, I'm telling y'all, this right here has been a process, and it's just up. I've been really good. I ain't been bothering nobody. I've been real patient, you know what I'm saying? And now my patience is tested. You know what I'm saying? The title company said about on or before the 12th. Like, you totally get it, but like, I'm so tired. I just cancel out all disconnections now. my internet was supposed to be canceled out tomorrow. Like, it's just so much stuff. Like, I'm tired of moving stuff. I was supposed to have been off today, but I'm actually going into work. You know what I'm saying? I might as well go into work probably the whole rest of the week, because I just got a feeling. Some fuckery, and I hate to say it like that. It's going to happen, and I'm tired, y'all. Countdown is happening. I'm to the point now, like, should I put my stuff in storage just in case if this stuff don't go through right? I just don't want to put my stuff in storage, take it back out, and move to, you know what I'm saying? But it's looking like that, because I'm to the point where now I don't even want to deal with this shit no more. Like, seriously, that's where I'm at. Alrighty, so today is Thursday. I just went ahead and just kept my day off for today and tomorrow. And right now, I'm at an ultimatum where if we don't hear anything back from the title company before, or the 12th, or if they're asking for more time, we are to walk away from this house. Today, I am going to be with my agent, and we're going to be looking at two houses, trying to get the third house. But right now, it's occupant, so yeah, that is what's going on. I'm already to the point where, even though I am looking for a house at this time, I am probably not going to have to move in with relatives until, you know what I'm saying, until everything gets situated. There's pros and cons to that. I'm not happy. I just really, I'm just upset a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Not even saying a little bit. I'm really upset because, you know, I was set. You know, I've been going through this process since the last week of December. So yeah, I am on the move to get these eyebrows together, because they looking a little crazy. Got a little string of strings, and I might tell her to thin them out a little bit more. So yeah, it's gonna hurt, but it is what it is. And so I'm doing that, and then within the next 2 hours I will be looking at the first house, second house, and we'll go from there. So, and then after that I will be moving stuff into storage. Okay, so so far my day, I looked at two houses. Oh my gosh, y'all, the first house was so freaking cute, and I should have took a video of it, but you know what, y'all, there was something going on with that foundation. I'm not going for foundation. The basement was dry, but it was a crack. Like, when you go to the first room, which could have been my office, you know, I try to imagine everything. And this first house, it had 2-car garage, it had 4 bedrooms. Like, it had a bedroom downstairs, and then, you know, has a kitchen, a kitchen, a living room, dining room, of course. And then it had its own separate room, and it had like built-in shelving in the back. And I was like, oh my god, that could be my office. And then later on, you go upstairs, it's like 3 small rooms, and then there's also attic room too. Right now, while I was eating breakfast, before I go look at the houses, I went ahead and got a storage unit, because I was planning on moving stuff to storage like today. Okay, now when I meet up with my agent, she pretty much tells me I need to send you these emails. And I said, okay. So, you know, she sent me the emails, and it shows that the title company, have an agreement with the seller for escrowing 5x amount. Like, oh my god, what, how much does she owe? So going forward, it says in the email that we are set to close tomorrow. So today is Thursday the 11th, and set to close for tomorrow. And I'm hoping and praying, y'all, this is it. Like, I'm so serious. So not only did I already purchase mine, I'm probably gonna lose some money, it's okay, towards getting my storage unit, I don't know, we'll see. I just now gotta go cancel it, like, you know what I'm saying, because I have it set in the email that it said. But you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and cancel it. But I am supposed to be also scheduled for the walkthrough later today as well. So The two houses that I did look at today, they were okay. The first house, like I said, the foundation, it had 4 bedrooms, 2-car garage. It was very nice. The uniqueness to the house was beautiful, but it's just, I could tell it was going to be either plug issues, because you know, when I get a full inspection, it's like, you know what I'm saying. The other house, oh my god, they redid the porches, which was beautiful. On the basement, and now it was told to me that a girl was supposed to close on this house, but she ended up getting a loan for $50,000 and thought that they probably wasn't going to know about it, and they had to cancel out her contract. So yeah, because they do a whole credit check, whatever case on you. But it's just the whole crazy thing about this. The house is nice. The rooms are a little small. I have a king size bed, so when I actually look at rooms, I want to make sure my bed can fit in them. But in this case, it was really it was so bad, like where my son's crib, you know what I'm saying, like even putting his crib in one of the rooms was kind of questionable. But what I really like, when you go upstairs, there's 2 rooms side by side, and there's doors on the other side of the rooms where there's an actual front porch that you can, you know, both go into. I was so in love with that, because I could have used that room for, like, one room could have been my closet, or could have been an office, or, you know what I'm saying, it could have even already imagined an office downstairs. But it was just really nice. That was really unique. I like how the 2 rooms have a door so you can go to the outside of, like, the little, it's like a little porch sit down area. Really nice with windows and everything. I'm so mad I should have got a video of this. But none of those houses will work out, as far as, like I said, I'm looking for space. I want to make sure my beds can fit in there. I'm not sure I got enough room. The second house would have been doable, but I wouldn't have had no space for my bed, you know. I just would have been on, like, one side of the room, and that would have been it. But the way how the rooms were, it was hard to, you know, determine, like, where exactly where my bed would have went. So, and no, I'm not downgrading my bed. I'm sorry. I'm not. So, going forward, I am now here at the storage place, because I had already had in mind that I was going to put everything in storage today. Until now, I finally get it. But I did tell, I said, if we don't hear anything by tomorrow, that's it. You know what I'm saying? If they also needed more time, that's it. I'm not going to keep going back and forth about this house. So it seems as though I'm going to have a busy weekend. So stay tuned. Okay, so today is Friday, and I went to Home Depot, had to get a couple of things. One thing that I really am needing to get is, I want to change all my locks to my house. Went to Home Depot, I was like, how does this work? Like, I'm a newbie here. So the lady tells me pretty much that, once I know for sure, because I for sure know that the back and the front is deadbolt. I don't know, maybe the side, I'm not sure, I don't remember. So I'm gonna have to, once I get in the house tomorrow, I totally forgot this part, guys. Get my keys tomorrow, guys. I'm getting my keys. Look. I'm like, really, 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 okay, yes, yes, I'm excited. So I am finishing. It's so echoey in here now. I got all types of stuff over here now, like I'm moving everything that was in here all the way again to the front. I just called my internet service to change my internet service. I told my boss I'm gonna need an extra 2 more days just to get everything situated in the house, you know, running around, all the above, etc., etc. I'm just like out freaking time, guys. Like, I'm not even kidding. Like, it's been like, y'all know y'all with me throughout this journey. You'll see me in my high, you saw me at my low, you see me in my middle, you know what I'm saying? You see me all through just a lot of it's just a lot of emotion that I had to go through with this process. And I've been going through this process with this house since the end of December, and it is like February, the day before Valentine's Day, that I'm going to be finally getting my keys. So I'm really, really excited about that. It's just
I feel like part of the weight on my chest is finally letting up, but at the same time, y'all, it's just getting everything together. I got movers coming tomorrow. I'm also going to get a truck right after I get my keys, like going to get the truck, like straight get the truck and move the truck and, you know, move everything that's needed. I'm just like, holy moly, you know what I'm saying? It's just, I don't even know how to feel now. Also, I have to, because my lips are so freaking dry. Also, I need to figure out what type of brand of the garage do I have, because I need to get a garage opener. Like, so crazy. Like, how do y'all lose the garage door? Whatever. I mean, I can either get the same brand or I can get the universal one. So we'll see. I mean, I don't know what all they may need, but they just told me that as long as I know the brand or I can get a universal, whatever they do. I said, I'll be back tomorrow. So not only do I have to place 4 door locks, I'm gonna have to get a key also for the garage. Like, oh my gosh. It is what it is. But one thing for sure, 2 for certain, I definitely want to need to get my door handles all changed, keys, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna need to do all that. Is that too loud? Let me see. I don't want to be copyrighted, y'all. Let me tell y'all, okay? Guys, y'all don't understand. Maybe y'all do, but man, let me tell y'all, I can finally get out of this house for sure. I didn't broke down my everything over here. And I got all my machines up now. I even got my printer here, and then my last 2 Crickets, I finally put them up. This shelf, my nephew came up with a good idea, because this was the tall shelf that my Crickets was on. He's saying pretty much that I should go ahead and put like a middle shelter. So I need to find a, my lips, y'all. I just need to find a slab of wood, like thick, nice wood, where I could put it in on the side, and actually I could have this as my station to do my printing and my cutting. So I definitely want to do that for my office. Okay, I think it would help if I would like tighten you guys down to the daggone tripod. But yeah, like all my lights and everything. And then my living room. Oh my gosh, y'all. My living room looks like utter daggone mess. It is just crazy. I need to vacuum out the couches and everything. My son loves to put stuff under the couches, so I didn't lift it up the couches too, and just like, okay. I am currently missing my remote to my TV. Remote been missing for 2 days, so it might be underneath the couches. It's somewhere in an odd place. So yes, there's my living room right now, looking a hot mess. But most of this stuff, I want this stuff moved to the house before the movers come and get the bigger stuff. So that is my plan. We're gonna see how that goes.